Good day. Here are the stories for the Manila Times for Friday, July 30, 2021. Government officials on Thursday continued to argue whether tighter quarantine restrictions should be imposed in the National Capital Region to head off a surge in COVID-19 cases triggered by the highly contagious Delta variant. The debate continued even as 97 new cases of the Delta variant were detected in the country on Thursday, pushing the total to 216. The Department of Health said 88 of the 97 Delta variant cases were from local transmission and 6 were returning overseas Filipinos. President Rodrigo Duterte on Thursday ordered the police and barangay officials to discourage unvaccinated people from leaving their homes since they are walking spreaders of COVID-19. In his weekly Talk to the People program, Duterte urged individuals who refuse to get inoculated to stay at home to prevent the spread of the virus, especially with the threat of the more contagious Delta variant. India and the Philippines are finalizing an agreement for harnessing renewable energy sources. Ambassador of India to the Philippines, Shambhu Kumaran, said on Thursday the two countries are fine-tuning the Memorandum of Understanding on Energy Cooperation. Kumaran said the MOU will be signed very quickly so that it will provide an avenue for a structured dialogue on policies and programs on harnessing renewable sources. He said one of the salient points of the planned collaboration is the business-to-business or commercial transactions between Indian and Filipino companies. Professional boxer Yumir Marshall of the Philippines came to the Tokyo Olympics as the favorite to dominate the middleweight division. In his debut fight at the Kokugikan Arena in Tokyo on Thursday, the pugilist from Zamboanga City did not disappoint. The 25-year-old needed only 2 minutes and 41 seconds to dispose of Algerian Yunis Nemuchi. The referee had to end the bout with 19 seconds left in the first round to prevent further damage to the deep cut above Nemuchi's right eye caused by an accidental bumping of heads with Marshall. But even before the injury, Marshall was already punishing Nemuchi with a combination of punches. He even floored the Algerian with a right hook at the 1 minute 59 second mark of the first round. Marshall later landed a solid left jab on Nemuchi's face with 1 minute 17 seconds left in the same round. The country's advisory panel on COVID-19 vaccines said it is open to giving booster shots to persons whose immune systems are compromised. Vaccine expert panel member and infectious diseases specialist Dr. Ronjean Solante said the group is looking at the possibility of administering boosters to patients with low antibody response to vaccines, such as persons living with HIV, cancer patients, senior citizens, and patients taking immunosuppressive drugs, such as persons with chronic kidney disease. A Social Weather Station survey showed the number of Filipino families who experienced involuntary hunger within the past 3 months has slightly decreased. The pollster said the hunger rate went down by 3.2%, from 16.8% in May 2021 to 13.6% in June, or equivalent to 3.4 million families. The overall hunger rate was the sum of the 11.5% who experienced moderate hunger and the 2.1% who experienced severe hunger. The survey said there was an overall decline in the number of people experiencing hunger in the country, especially in the Visayas. Over to business, the Bureau of the Treasury said the government's outstanding debt reached a new high of 11.16 trillion pesos at the end of June due to increased domestic and external liabilities. The sum was up 0.9% or 94.9 billion pesos from 11.07 trillion pesos at the end of May, according to Treasury figures released on Thursday. Of the amount, 28.9% was secured from foreign creditors and 71.1% from the local ones. Domestic debt climbed by 0.3% to 7.93 trillion pesos in June, up from 7.91 trillion pesos in May, while external debt increased by 2.3% to 3.22 trillion pesos. There were 9.05 trillion pesos in outstanding obligations a year ago, with 6.19 trillion pesos in domestic debt and 2.86 trillion pesos in external debt. The Bureau said the growing domestic debt is due to net issue of government securities. In other Olympic news, rower Chris Nevarez, golfer Juvik Pagunsan, and swimmer Luke Gebby aim to have a better showing on Friday for the Philippines' campaign in the Tokyo Olympics. Nevarez, already out of medal contention, eyes a strong finish in the men's single sculls. Pagunsan, who manages to stay within striking distance with opening round leaders, seeks a better showing in the second round in the men's individual stroke play. And Gebby faces monumental odds in gunning for a semifinal berth in the men's 50-meter freestyle event. Rigoberto Tiglao and Ruben Torres are today's front page columnists. Tiglao believes the Duterte administration is triumphant, while Torres discusses the first Philippine Olympic gold medal. Today's editorial is about the mental health of athletes participating at the Olympic Games. Read a full version on the paper's opinion section or listen to the Voice of the Times. Key figures in the Philippine financial sector will provide perspectives on the country's economic prospects amid the COVID-19 pandemic in the Manila Times Mid-Year Economic Report on Friday, July 30. This edition will evaluate if the Philippines' economic estimates are on track with only 5 months left of 2021. Banco Central ng Pilipinas Governor Benjamin Diokno will be the keynote speaker. He will share his perspectives and updates on the central bank's important policies that include increasing financial inclusion and making digital payments and electronic commerce more accessible to Filipinos. Philippine National Bank President and CEO and Philippine Bankers Association of the Philippines President Jose Arnulfo Wick Veloso and Aftad Ahmed, City Philippines Country Head and City Country Officer, will also deliver their respective speeches. The forum will be moderated by Times President and CEO Dante Klinkang II and business columnist Reynaldo Ray Lugtu. See you there. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print, subscribe to its digital edition, or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, and keep up with the Times. On behalf of the Manila Times, this is Arik John Cico reporting. Have a safe Friday ahead.